at Mines and Money 2016. I am very pleased to be joined by Tony Polglase, Managing Director of Avanco Resources, and Colin James, the Chairman of the company, a company listed on the Australian Stock Exchange. It's a copper and gold producer with mines projects in northern Brazil. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Tony, I'd like to start with you, please, and your latest news. It's this crushing upgrade.
Yes. We've recently completed the construction and installation of a crushing plant upgrade at our Antas mine in the north of Brazil. Antas is our first project, producing around about 12,000 tonnes of copper per year, plus 7,000 ounces of gold. We are looking at increasing the capacity of the plant, and one of the areas that we feel we need to upgrade is the crushing area, and we are expecting that upgrade to be finished by the end of this month, whereby we can then begin to lift the production capacity of the mine. The mine is working extremely well. We built the mine in approximately 9 months on time, and we built it under budget, which is quite incredible since we did this in Brazil. And most people say Brazil is a difficult place to work, but in fact for us, we've been very successful there.
And you've mentioned the fact that this crushing upgrade will obviously help you lift up current production levels. Can you give us a few more figures, be a bit more specific about that?
Right. To date, we've been producing at a nominal 1,000 tonnes per month of copper metal in concentrates that we ship to the north of Brazil and onward to a customer in Asia. We're anticipating being able to lift that by at least 10% in the new year, and we're making plans to do that. And as I said, the crushing upgrade is one of those components which is well advanced to completion. In terms of overall, we feel that we can probably go further than that, but one step at a time.
And what about this new project you've acquired from Codelco?
Yes, Antas is our first project. However, we did acquire a second project several years ago, and we're advancing that project. That project's called Pedra Branca. It's probably 3 to 4 times bigger than Antas, and is where the future of the company lays. That project, we feel, has capacity ultimately to produce something in excess of an additional 35,000 tonnes a year of copper. We have been using our operating cash flow from Antas to fund the development of Pedra Branca so far. However, in the interim, we have acquired a new project a short distance from Pedra Branca, from Codelco, obviously one of the world's biggest producers, and we will be exploring there in the new year. At Pedra Branca itself, development activities started a few months ago, and perhaps Colin, can you give us an update on that?
Yes, although I'm not executive chairman, I've taken a particular interest in Pedra Branca as it's underground, and most of my experience is underground. We've started a box cut, and fresh off the press is a photograph of the portal position. So we're at the portal. Within the next 2 or 3 weeks, we'll open the portal and we'll start the decline. The intention is initially to carry out development on sublevels, with the development ore going back to Antas for processing. And again, that feeds into the extra crushing capacity that we have at Antas now. Obviously, with the higher copper price, we would like to develop the full mine at Pedra Branca, and we think it could be between 1.6 and 2 million tonnes a year. Grade slightly better than Pedra Branca, and we would obviously need a concentrator, a dedicated concentrator at Pedra Branca.
So let's talk a bit more about copper prices, actually. How do you assess the market currently?
There's been a significant increase in relative terms of the price of copper over the last few weeks. For that reason, we're revisiting our budgets and our development alternatives going forward. We're approximately probably generating double the amount of operating margins from what we were a few weeks ago. So even though the price is only 50 cents higher than it was 3 weeks ago, that makes a huge difference to our operating cash flow. What does that do for us? Well, we've probably got a market cap today of around about 120 million US dollars. We've got $20 million in the bank, With the expectation of more cash flow coming into the company, we're stepping up our what is an already aggressive expansion outlook. We're pursuing a number of properties in the immediate area, which is dominated by a major, and this increase in copper price will support us as we go forward.
Fantastic, gentlemen. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thanks.